and I was out of the picture for a while. Now if we go down to the dally, let's see what we have here. What do we have for the dally? Now we look at the dally. And here's our compression right here, and then angle and separation all the way up until it crosses and compresses right there. So we exit the trade. That would be kind of like a false entry, because then it went then it just kind of went back and forth for a while. And this time it crossed and angled and separated right here. We have space there going all the way down. It went all the way up, crossed, and then angle and separated and crossed right there again. Now we're starting to get angle and separation. So this is giving us the that leg that we were looking for. Something like that. Let's see here. We put our candles back in there. You'll be able to see what's going on here. Okay, so what else do we have here? An AB equals CD leg? Oh yeah, that's right, we do. We also have another AB equals CD going on here. Going right from there to there. We draw another one in. There to there. Draw it from there to there. Scrunch the chart up a little bit. And you can see we still have a little bit of ways right here to get down to that level. This is another AB equals CD. A, B, then you have your center leg right there, C, D, on the dally. So what we're waiting for is price to finish its little thing right here, turn over, head down to our spot right there, and then make a reversal. Now, we're looking for, we're wanting to look left and see if we can see any structure. So we draw us a little line right there, and we move our chart. And looky right there, there's our structure right there on that red line. See that? That point right there is where we have structure. Now, put the chart back and we shrink it down a bit. Oops. Shrink it down a bit again. There we go. Now we can get a better view of what our structure looks like. Because here's our ABCD again. Here's A. Here's B. Here's C. And it's going down for D. Once it makes the D point, then it's going to go up for a period of time. Now, what we want to do is get our Fibonacci tool, go swing high to swing low, and see what kind of confluence we have. And right down here, we have what's known as the 127 1.272 or the 127.2. This is the 127.2 level. And that's right here at this point right there. And that's real good confluence. That's telling us that things are going on. What the heck's going on here? We don't want this. Go away. Thank you. Okay. Now, if we do another Fibonacci, let's see if we have some more confluence here. If we go down to here, and we draw that swing low to that swing high up there, see what other kind of confluence we get. We're not getting anything right there. Nothing at all, so now if you notice right down here, we have another line right here, this white line right here. This is 161.8. This is a Fibonacci level. And if you notice, if we draw another red line at that level, let's see if we have any structure. No, we don't. There's nothing. We do have this point right here. We have this point right here, but however, price is not really touching the line there. There's a little gap there. It could still be something. It could still go down there close. It doesn't have to all go all the way down to the 168. Let's shrink this up a little more. Oh, that's as far as it shrinks. Let's see if we... Oh, look at this. Look what we have down here. Do the chart a little bit further back. What do we have? Oh, man. We have 2 points touching the 161.8 right there. Look at that. Look at that. Now what we do is we go to the weekly time frame, we'll be able to see that better. There it is. The weekly time frame. Look at that. Now if we go back to the daily, here's our top red line right here. See right there? There's a top red line. There's a point. We go over here, go further in time. We have a point here touching. And all this right in here. So we have that, you know, we have a zone going on right here is what we have. See that? In between those two red lines, So more than likely, price is probably gonna go down in this, have a zone area in between those two points. Now if we do a red line here, let's see what this red line gets us. Gets us down to this area. A third red line gets us down to around this area down here. And we have some price could float. Oops. We have some price. Get my little lighted up. We have some prices in this area. Prices going on. Lit up in that area. So if we zoom back out to the daily or the weekly, we can see. Alright, let's see if we can get our chart to move now. Okay, there we go. We can see we have a few different ranges here to be, see what's going on. So we go back to our daily. Even if we go back to our 4 hour, scrunch up the charty charter. Okay, this is where we're looking for price to go down to, is right there. In between those lines there. Scrunch the chart up a little bit more. There we go. So there's our zone right there. So this is our target zone. So we're waiting for price to go down there. And so price can either go down here. It only has another 100 pips to go down, 150 pips or so from where it's at right now. Now it could go down there and bounce. It could bounce and go up for resistance. Or it could break through, go back up for a retest, and bounce and go down to this next line of resistance. And then it could bounce up and go from there. Or it could, once it bounces, it could bounce and go in between this channel for a while, make a little flag pattern or pennant. And then it could break to the downside, go up for a retest, and then start heading down again. Starts heading down again. You know, it could head down to, we have a big gap. We'd have a big move all the way down to there. Actually, hit the Firefox open button. And if we do that, then we're going to have a big, how many pips is that? That's a 500 pip move there, if it goes there. So get everything to where it is today. Now, if we look at price where we're at right now, as far as getting down there.